this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you some very useful expressions and how to apply them. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. Let's dive right in and first of all, add a simple shape layer by double-clicking on the rectangle tool. We open the rectangle path property and scale the shape down. Next, let's add an expression to, let's say, the rotation property by clicking on the stopwatch symbol while holding Alt if you use a PC or Option if you're using a Mac, which opens the expression field. Let's add our first expression, which is my absolute favorite, a time expression. We add time and then asterisk 50, which adds 50 degrees to the rotation value per second. This is great for continuous and linear movements. Let's add it to the position property. We add an expression and add time asterisk 50 again, which doesn't work. Because the time expression is one-dimensional, the position value two-dimensional, x and y. No problem, we simply separate the dimensions and add time asterisk 200 to the x position, which adds 200 pixels per second to the x position value, starting at 0. If you want your start value to be 500 pixels, for example, you simply add it, plus 500. What about the scale value though? You can't separate the dimensions here. We need to establish a variable first. Let's say we want to scale the x value with the time expression. X equals time asterisk 50. Be careful because it's percent. Plus 100, we want to start at 100%. Semicolon. Then we add a value. Square brackets and inside x the variable, comma 100 our fixed y value. And the x value scales up by 50% per second. I mostly use the time expression to animate the evolution of noise in the turbulent noise effect. But what if we wanted to be less fluent and give it a more handmade look? We use the posterizeTime expression. But why not just use the effect? We could do that. The difference is the expression applies to a single property and doesn't affect the whole layer. Like the effect. Let's add posterizeTime above the time expression. Add 8 frames per second in parentheses and a semicolon at the end. Awesome! I animated the shape here with 2 position keyframes. Let's add the expression to the position property. 4 frames per second this time. Which you can't do. You need to add a value it refers to. So you need to add a semicolon and in the next line transform.position dot value, for example. And the frame rate for the position property is reduced to 4 frames per second. For more content, you might want to join my newsletter. It'll help you to improve as a motion designer. Link is in the description below and there might be an exclusive freebie waiting for you. Let's take a look at the wiggle expression, which basically creates random movement. We add an expression to the position property of a shape. Add wiggle. And in parentheses, 2,50. Which means 2 times per second, the position wiggles max 50 pixels in each direction. Additionally, let's add it to the scale property. Wiggle in parentheses 0,5,20. And let's add it to the rotation property as well. Wiggle in parentheses 1,100. And finally, let's wiggle the opacity. We add wiggle and 3,50 in parentheses. Awesome. If you add a few more shapes in different colors and sizes and add an adjustment layer on top, you can create amazing animated backgrounds by adding different blur effects. CC cross blur, for example, or CC radial blur. Fastbox blur for a smooth color gradient. I would recommend to add some noise as well to avoid color bending. Which other expressions should I cover in one of my next videos? Let me know in the comments below. Another useful thing you can do easily with expressions is to pin your anchor point to a corner or the center of a shape. Wherever you add a shape, the anchor point is at the center of the layer, not the shape we just created. And by default, it scales in all directions, which is not what you always want. So let's open the anchor point property and add an expression. We We start with establishing a variable. A, like anchor point, equals source rect at time. Semicolon. The source rect at time expression reads the width and height of a shape at the current time. Then we add a value, square brackets, and inside a.left, a.top, which pins the anchor point to the top left corner. If you scale the shape now, it behaves differently. Let's add plus a.width to the x value. The point moves along the whole width to the right corner. If we divide the width by 2, it's in the top center point. Let's add plus a.height to the y value. And the point moves all the way down. We divide the height by 2, it's in the center. Let's delete that again so that it's back in the bottom center. And add a wiggle expression to the rectangle path size. Wiggle, and in parentheses, 2,300 for example. And you can see that the bottom edge doesn't move. The size changes in only 3 directions. Take another look at the expressions in the free project file. Let me know which other expressions I should cover. Join my newsletter for more content. Learn more about expressions in the next video here on the left. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.